You.
No, first we love.
Yeah. Yes, everyone. So I need to pull the today topic is SAP accounting entry posting. I want to post salary account data to cash. So already this salary GL and cash GL yesterday I created. This is the salary account. Yesterday means last class. Salary account, and this is the cash account. Salary means 44001. Cash means 22000, right? So I need to post this accounting entry. Where I want to post? This one. General document posting single screen. What is the T code? FB50. FB50. So SAP menu, I am showing path. SAP menu, accounting, financial accounting, general ledger, document entry, enter GL accounts. Enter GL account. The T code is FB50. FB50. So open the SAP. And enter username and password. See this one, everyone, please follow. SAP menu, go on mute. SAP menu, accounting, financial accounting, general ledger, document entry. First one, what is this? Enter GL accounts. Enter GL accounts. You just double click on this. You just double click on this. Note it down. If you post, note it down, John. If you post any document entry, if you post,
I'm ready.
Yeah, please note it down. If you post any document entry, any document entry, there is two types of data available. One is header data and one is line item data. One is header data and one is line item data. See this one. Whatever information you are enter here, example document date, posting date, reference, document header type, those all are the header data. Whatever information you are specified here, that is called line item data. Everyone, you please catch the point. Whatever information enter here, this is called header data and this is called line item data. You please note it down the next line. The document classified into two datas, more information. Atama maldiyach letama maldidam letama. Same way, you please note it down, header data and line item data. Header data and line item data. Done? Yeah, everyone, listen carefully. Listen carefully. So I want to post accounting entry, salary account data to cash. You just double click on this. The first one is document date and posting date. What is meant by document date? For example, let's concentrate here. If you post vendor invoice accounting entry, everyone, please listen carefully. What is meant by document date? Document date means if you post vendor invoice posting, whatever date available in on physical document, that document is called document date. Everyone, for example, if you post any vendor invoice, whatever date available on physical document, on invoice, whatever date available on invoice, that date is called document date. What is meant by posting date? So that invoice, when you are posting into the system, on the invoice, date available 01/04/2020, example. What date available on invoice 01/04/2020? So this is called document date. So this document, when I am posting into the system, example 05/04/2020. So this is called posting date. Understood? But for the practice purpose, both you can take same date, that is not a problem. Okay, example, practice purpose, enter same date, 1/10/2020. Then currency, what is meant by currency? Listen careful. Whatever currency you are specified into this field, that currency is called transactional currency. Everyone, once again I'm repeating, whatever currency you are specified at the time of accounting entry posting, that currency is called transactional currency. Okay, example, I am giving salaries USDs. I am giving salaries to American person. So which currency I give? USD. Example, I am giving the person to American person. I give USD. I give salary to Mr. John. John is staying in Europe. So I give, which currency I give? EUR. This right? EUR. So whatever currency you are specified at the time of accounting entry posting, that currency is called transactional currency. Okay, example, let's take INR. Then reference GL posting. Okay, then here debit and credit. And what is the debit and what is the credit? Go to Excel. See here, salary account data to cash. Salary goes to debit and cash goes to credit. And before going to and salary and cash, you please understand here document type. We already discussed document type. What is meant by document type? Document type is classified accounting entries. So for example, if you post GL document, you need to enter SA. If you post vendor invoice, you need to enter KR. If you post customer invoice, you need to enter DR, like that. Example I am showing. Okay, so now I am posting, but Vendor invoice, you need to post different T-code. Customer invoice, you need to post different T-code. Now we are posting GL invoice. What is the T-code? FB50. Okay. So what is the document type for GL posting? SA. GL accounting. Now enter here debit and credit. So what is the debit? Salary account data to cash. And yesterday, I mean last class we created. Salary to cash. Salary to cash. This is the salary. And this is the cash. Right. And enter here. This is the debit. And this is the credit. Right. And how much amount? 10,000. And 10,000 and slash 10,000, then tap, enter the tab button in the keyboard. If you want to write any narration, you can write it. Then enter your business area here. What is meant by business area? Business area nothing but branch. So you are giving salary, right? This salary belongs to which branch or which business area? In the SAP terminology, don't call as a branch. Okay, in the when you go to real time, you don't call as a branch, you need to call as a business area. Okay, you need to call as a business area. So this salary belongs to which business area? So select here. We are created different business areas. Like what is our business area here, right? Like GM Bangalore business area, GM Hyderabad business area, Mumbai business area. You need to select anyone. Example, Hyderabad business area, GM HY. Okay, and tap. And which profit center? This salary belongs to which profit center? I need to enter like GM 10, right? GM 10, press enter. So you need to specify it here. So everyone here, you just catch the point. One more point. If you double click on, if you go to any accounting entry, first you need to check your company code. Okay, first you are checking your company code. Click on your company code. This is CM10. What is our company code? Our company code is GM10, right? CM10, and click on here enter. So as usual, document date and currency, posting date and GL posting, document type SA. What is the debit? Debit is salary and 44001 and cash and the debit and credit. Then value 10,000, then 10,000. And business area, then profit center. The segment pick automatically. Everyone please understand properly. I entered business area and I enter profit center. The segment pick automatically. Why? Why means at the time of profit center creation, I assigned segment. At the time of profit center creation, I assigned a segment. So that is the reason segment will pick automatically. So press enter button in the keyboard. Then click on your simulate. So what is this? salary account data to cash. Salary account data to cash. Then click on your post. If you post successfully accounting entry, it means your all the configuration is correct. Okay, if any errors is occurred, there is a some configuration is missing. Okay, so go to document, click on your display. See here, display document data in entry view. This is the entry view. This is an entry view. And see here, this is business area, profit center and segment. Segment will pick automatically. Why? Because at the time of profit center creation, I assigned the segment. Okay. And this is the entry view and this is the general ledger view. This is the entry view. This is the general ledger view. This is an entry view, general ledger view. And how many currencies reflected? Example, this is the INR. This is INR. And click on your display currency. And I am selecting group currency. What is my group currency? My group currency is USD. Click on here. See here, it changed to USD. Then click on your display currency. What is my local currency? INR. Click on your local currency, INR. And click on display currency. Document currency. Document currency means transactional currency. Document currency means it's an a transactional currency. So select your document currency, click on your OK. It is also same INR. So how many ledgers generated? Three ledgers. What is that? So other ledger, see this one, 0L leading ledger, G1 US GAAP for non-leading ledger, G2 IFRS for non-leading ledger. The value should be updated all the ledgers. For example, you just double click on this. This is 0L and select, click on your G1. This is the G1. See here. And select here G2. This is the G2 value. Okay. Are you following everyone? For your understanding, yes, purpose, one more accounting entry I am posting. The accounting entry is called cash account data to Suresh Capital. Cash account data to Suresh Capital. 10th example, 20,000 and 20,000. Cash account data to Suresh Capital. Okay. And here, see here, we already created Suresh Capital and we are already created cash. So cash account data to capital. Cash account data to capital. Cash means 220000. Capital means 100000. So these two things we need to post. So how to post? And come to this path, SAP menu, accounting, financial accounting, and general ledger, document entry. This one, double click on FB50. You just double click on this. As usual, document date and posting date. Enter document date and posting date. Example, I am giving example. Let's take document currencies for your understanding purpose. Let's take EUR, Europe currency. I received capital from Paris. Example, I received capital from Paris. Mr. Suresh Capital, right? Is Suresh staying in France? So which currency is transfer? he transferred Europe, EUR. So whatever currency you are specified here, that is called document currency or transactional currency. Example, document date, posting date, and reference, and and document type, debit and credit. What is the debit? Debit is the cash. Debit is the cash. Credit is the Suresh capital. Credit is the capital. Example, cash 220000 and capital 10000, like that. And this is the debit and this is credit. How much value? Example, 20,000 euros. 20,000 euros. 20,000 euros. And if you want to write narration, you can write it here. So as usual, belongs to which business area and belongs to which profit center, he sent for which profit center. Then press enter button in the keyboard, then click on your simulate. See here which currency reflected? Euro. Then click on your simulate. See this one, cash account data to capital, means Suresh capital. Then click on your post, go to document and display. Go to document and display. So this is the entry view and this is the ledger view. This is the entry view, whatever you are seeing, and click on your general ledger view, and this is other ledgers, and this is currency. So when you click on your currency, click on your local currency, click on your OK. What is my local currency? INR. My local currency is INR. And click on your other currency and group currency. Click on your group currency. What is my group currency? USD. See here, USD. Then click on your display. What is my document currency? Euro. Click on your OK. See here, my this document currency is Euro. And other ledgers, 0L, G1, G2, like that. Anyone, any doubts? Do one thing.
I have one doubt here.
Tell me, Navin.
So when we are posting, go to the SAP screen once.
Okay, please.
FB50.
When I double click on FB50.
Yes. Open. Here in line item data, we are specifying the business area. So do we need to enter both the lines or only one line?
If you enter debit side, the credit side automatically pick. The value should be automatically pick. If you enter credit side, debit side automatically update in the backend.
Okay, so that means we have to enter the business area only one, either debit or
credit. I understood. Everyone, please catch here. What is the Navin doubt means? Whatever parameters you are specified, like business area, profit center and segment, if these parameters you need to specify both side, debit side or credit side, or you need to specify only one side, this is the Navin doubt, correct?
Yes, Venkat.
Yeah, means if you specified debit side, the credit side backend automatically update. If you specified credit side, the debit side automatically update. This is the one feature of document splitting. Okay.
Okay.
For example, see here. For example, if you debit side, Hyderabad business area. In credit side also Hyderabad will be update. But if you want to debit side Hyderabad and credit side Bangalore, you must enter. How the automatically information update? If you enter debit side Hyderabad, credit side also automatically pick Hyderabad. But sometime debit side is different, credit side is different. So that time you need to manually enter debit side Hyderabad, credit side Bangalore, like that. If you automatically update, means same value update in the automatically. If maybe differ, you need to enter manually. Okay, got it? Naveen?
Yes, I got it already.
Yeah. See this one. And one more accounting entry I am posting. One more accounting entry I need to post. One more accounting entry. One more accounting entry. I want to post example admin expenses account data to cash. Admin account data to cash. Admin expenses account data to cash. Example B. Listen carefully. I want to post that accounting entry with double screen F-02. I want to post here. General document posting double screen F-02. See here, everyone, please understand here. What is the difference between FB50 and F-02? What is the difference between FB50 and F-02? The functionally there is a no change. FB50 or F-02 both are same, but FB50 is the single screen. Single screen means like debit side information and credit side information, header data and line item data, both are single screen. But when you go to F-02, there is a double screen. That is the difference. When I post accounting entry FB50 with a single screen, all the information available in single screen. But if I post F-02, there is a double screen. Means debit side information is one screen, credit side information is another screen. The functionally, if you post accounting entry in the FB50 or if you post accounting entry in the F-02, there is a no change. Both are same. But change is, this is the single screen, this is the double screen. That's it. The functionally no change. Okay. Example, which accounting entry I want to post? Where I say, yeah. So this accounting entry I need to post. So what is the path? Example, SAP menu, accounting, financial accounting, general ledger, document entry and general posting, F-02 T code. FB50 and F-02 both are same. There is a no changes. But the changes is, this is used for the single screen, this is used for the double screen. That's it. Okay. And go to F-02, for example, see here, F-02, double click on this and select here, example document date and document type means SCA, then company code GM10, posting date, month, currency and reference. This document number pick automatically, and reference GL postings. So this is the line 40 means debit. What is the debit? Debit is admin expenses. Credit is cash. What is the admin expenses number? Admin expenses is this one. Admin expenses. See here, document date, posting date, everything is same. There is a no changes, but they and FB50 single screen, F-02 double screen. That's it. Everything both are same. Document date, posting date, document type, month, company code, currency, GL posting. 40 means debit and enter the GL admin expenses. Press enter button in the keyboard. Press enter button in the keyboard and enter the value, example 30,000. Then click on your more. Click on your more. Then enter business area, profit center, and segment. What is our business area? GMHY, Hyderabad business area. What is our profit center? GM100. The segment will pick automatically. You leave that one. And here pick, see here, segment I didn't enter, but it can be updated. When I click on your more, here I didn't enter. This will pick automatically. Why? Because at the time of profit center creation, I assigned the segment. Okay. Then write the description. Being GL posting. Then the 50 means credit. 50 means credit. Then cash. What is the cash number? 22000. Press enter. For example, if you enter the amount, you can enter. Otherwise, when you click on your star means copy the amount debit side to credit side. And here click on your plus. What is meant by plus? Copy the text debit side to credit side. Okay, press enter. If you want to enter value, you can enter. Otherwise, put as a star, copy the amount, put as a plus, copy the text, press enter. See here, and go to document, click on your simulate. See this one, admin expenses, account data to cash. Then click on your post and go to document, click on your display. See, no changes, same to same. This is the entry view and this is the ledger view, and entry view and ledger views, both are same. And currencies, document currency, local currency, group currency, and ledgers, other ledgers, leading ledgers and non-leading ledgers. The functional wise both are same. What is the both? FB50 and F-02 both are same. Okay, but here the single screen and here the double screen, that's it. Okay, and I will tell you the last one. I will explain you. See, everyone, please catch the point here. If I post even, basically this is the interview question also. This is interview question also. Everyone, be careful. If I post any document entry, three ledgers will be reflected, right? Three ledgers. Three ledgers. What is that? 0L, leading ledger, G1, US GAAP, G2, IFRS. If you post document entry, three ledgers will be reflected. Okay. But now client requirement is, I don't want to post accounting entry in the three ledgers. I want to post only G1 ledger. Example, do one thing. I want to post admin expenses account data to example. I want to post admin expenses account data to cash. I don't want to reflect 0L ledger and 02 ledger. I want to reflect only G1 ledger. What can I do? The value is example. Value is 200 rupees. That's it. 200 rupees. And this is the admin expenses. What is the cash number? 220000. Admin expenses. What is the number? Admin expenses. This one, right? 400000. So where is that? Yeah, here. So did you understand my requirement, everyone? Harish, are you understand my requirement? My requirement
is... Yes, sir, got it, sir.
Got it, right? Very good. So I want to post admin expenses account data to cash with only single ledger. Okay? Yeah. How to post?
See, yes, sir.
Everyone, you just catch the point here. Everyone. If I post FB50 or F-02, if I post FB50 and F-02, three ledgers will be updated with three currencies. Someone is speaking, any doubt? So C1, if I use FB50 and F-02, three ledgers will be reflected and three currencies: local currency, group currency and transactional currency. But do one thing, both are same. But if I use FB50L, what happened? FB50L. FB50 means three ledgers will be reflected. If I use FB50L, see this one, FB50L. See here, the last one, see this one. Enter GL account document for ledger group, FB50L. You can use this one. What is the T code? FB50L. Go to FB50L. Everyone, catch the point here. Enter here, see this one. FB50L. Same path, SAP menu. Accounting, financial accounting, general ledger, document entry, FB50L. Double click on FB50L and document date and example document currency, posting date. See here, what is this? Ledger group. Here you need to enter G1. Here you need to specify G1. If you specified the G1, this accounting entry reflected on G1. Where is that? See this one. Concentrate here. If I specified G1, this accounting entry reflected on G1. If I specified G2, this accounting entry reflected on G2. If I specified 0L, this accounting entry reflected on 0L. Okay, got it my point? And as usual, same, GL posting. Like if you want to enter document type, everything same. Like Pawan Kalyan, same. Okay, and admin expenses. Hey John, do you know Pawan Kalyan? John, are you
sorry?
There? You know Pawan Kalyan? Pawan Kalyan, Mr. Pawan Kalyan.
Yeah, I'm here.
No, you are hearing, but I'm asking, who is Pawan Kalyan?
No.
He's a Tollywood superstar. Like cinema actor.
So, there is some blank while you are speaking. Oh. So I cannot hear a phrase.
Okay, no problem. That's not a subject. Okay, no problem. See here. Now
okay.
are you audible now?
Yeah, I can hear you. Yeah.
Okay. My question is, do you know Pawan Kalyan, Mr. Pawan Kalyan?
No, I don't know.
Okay. No problem. Actually, he's an movie actor.
Okay.
Indian movie actor.
Ah, okay.
Oh, yeah.
Ah, okay.
Yeah. Double 4 00 00 and 22. So admin expenses account dated to cash. This is the number, and debit and credit. Any doubts? Someone send the message. Everyone, are you able to hear my voice properly?
Yes, I can hear you, sir.
Yes, Venkat, we are hearing.
It is breaking, sir.
Yes.
Okay.
That's correct, Renuka.
So, are you able to understand if you...
We are understanding, Venkat.
Okay.
Yes, we can understand.
I have just a question.
Yes, please.
This point of specifying in what ledger that we have to book the entry.
Okay.
Hello?
Okay.
What is the interest of specifying in what ledger we have to book? As we know that when we use FB.
Yeah, the interest is, I got the point, John. The interest is, sometimes we need to post some adjustment accounting entries. That accounting entries you need to post like this way.
Okay.
Yeah, example 200. So, are you able to hear my voice, Venkat sir? Are you there? I don't know why my voice. Everyone, are you able to hear my voice? Harish?
Sir.
Yeah. And enter 200. And as usual, enter your business area and profit center. Then press enter button in the keyboard. Note it down, this error. Everyone, note it down. Please note it down. Yes, Anji, any doubts? Please note it down, this one. Why my voice is breaking? Please note it down. That's it. I'm not telling anything. Please note it down this. Everyone done? Just two lines, that's it.
Okay, that's fine.
Yeah, what is the solution? Note it down, the solution. The solution is, you need to create the number range. SPRO, SAP reference IMG. And select your financial accounting new, and select your general ledger, not general ledger, financial accounting global settings, document number ranges, entry view. Note it down the T code. Instead of path, you please note it down the T code. Like go to FBN1, go to FBN1, create number range. Enter here what is our group? GM10. Click on your change intervals. Then click on your add 98 2020 980002 980999. You please create one number range. Then click on your save. Create one. This is the solution. Okay, create number range and save. Everyone are able to hear my voice? Then again go to number range and this general ledger view, document in general ledger view, and double click on this. Enter your GM10, click on your change intervals and add 98 2020 980002 980999. Then click on your save. So what happened? I created number range for entry view, number range for general ledger view, both here FBN1 and here. One is this one. Define document number range for general ledger view and define document number range for entry view. Renuka, are you hear my voice?
Yes.
Yeah. So both number range we need to create. Okay. Done.
Nice music.
Yeah, now you can able to post. Go to FB50L and enter document date, currency, posting date, and G1 and GL posting. As usual, document type SCA and debit like 44000 and credit cash. And this going to debit, and this is the credit. This is the value 200 and 200, and tap, enter the tab button in the keyboard. Here if you want to write any narration, you can write it here. Then the business area, then profit center, press enter button in the keyboard. Then click on your simulate. Then post and go to document. Click on your display. Everyone click on your display. See here, for admin expenses data to cash. This is the entry view and this is the general ledger view. And see this one, there is no other ledgers updated. Only G1 should be updated. Okay guys, the reports, I'm sign out the class. Please join tomorrow. Okay, tomorrow is Saturday, right?
Actually,
Yeah, no problem. Please join today also. Okay.